As festividades começaram na Câmara Municipal de Brampton, onde a comunidade teve a oportunidade de assistir ao içar da bandeira portuguesa, evento que contou com a participação dos luso-canadianos vereador Martin Medeiros, Paul Vicente. Na cerimónia esteve também o presidente da Câmara de Brampton, Patrick Brown. O evento começou com o hino nacional do Canadá. Nos discursos, o reconhecimento da comunidade pelas contribuições feitas em várias áreas.
Today here it's our fourth annual, and this also is a celebration of Portuguese Heritage Month, and to recognize not only the Portuguese community, but also to celebrate the way that the city of Brampton has received the Portuguese community. I can tell you from having the opportunity to live in other countries where I see different immigrant groups and the way that they've integrated, we are certainly fortunate that the way that Brampton, this country, has opened their arms and allowed us to really receive and express our culture. Today is just another example of the way that the city of Brampton has really embraced diversity and inclusion. Certainly I have to recognize leadership of Mayor Patrick Brown and members of council who embraced not only today, but have embraced cultural diversity, celebration, and recognizing really the social fabric of what our city is. I would like to recognize, again, I had mentioned we have here Mayor Patrick Brown. We have our Chief of Police with us, and that's always an honor. Thank you for coming. Councillor Jeff Bowman. We have Councillor Charmaine Williams, Councillor Arthur Singh, Councillor Rowena Santos, a fellow Portuguese, Councillor Paul Vicente, and my good friend here, Councillor Pat Portini. Also, we have dignitaries, our MPs, and I know MP Ramesh Sangha, and Honorable Sonia Sidhu, who is a great champion for the Portuguese community and is always here supporting our events.
O presidente da Câmara de Brampton, Patrick Brown, aproveitou a oportunidade para agradecer à organização do evento e à comunidade e entregou a proclamação da herança portuguesa ao diretor do Correio da Manhã Canadá, Eduardo Vieira.
Thank you, Councillor Medeiros. Welcome to Kendall Square, to Brampton City Hall. And I just want to thank in particular Councillor Marta Medeiros and Paul Vicente, who have played such a leadership role in making sure this event is a success. They are passionate about Brampton, but they're passionate about their heritage. And what's more Canadian than that? You've got two phenomenal ambassadors for the Portuguese community here within our city's mosaic. We may be the only... Thank you, Ramesh Sangha, for starting that clap. But we may be the only city that has 20% of our city council that is of Portuguese heritage. I would note, I had the honor to go to Portugal twice. The first time 10 years ago with my youngest sister to Lisbon, and then more recently 2 years ago to the Algarve, to Porto Mayo, to Albufeira. And you can't go to the Algarve and not dream of going back. And Martin tells me that it's even nicer in the Azores. So it is, there you go, and there are too. It really is a pretty special place. And it's wonderful that in Brampton we have this special Portuguese community that makes Portugal a little bit closer to home. Because you can have the great food, you can have the sense of family here within the city limits of the city of Brampton. Pretty special that this weekend we also have the big festival, of course, at Garden Square. And so this weekend we are all Portuguese in the city of Brampton. And I want to thank you for all coming out today. We have a number of dignitaries that Marta mentioned, but of course from City Council, just to acknowledge, we have Pat Portini, Paul Vicente, Rowena Santos, Harthira Singh, Charmaine Williams, Councillor Jeff Bowman. We have quorum today. So we could pass anything we need to if there's anything wrong in the city. But of course, this presentation we're going to make of the proclamation is to Eduardo Vieira, the president of the Korea Banana in Canada, and one of the real icons in the community. And so I'm going to present this proclamation Eduardo, before I'll read it out first, and that is, whereas Portuguese Canadians have contributed tremendously to Brampton's economic, political, and cultural fabric, Portuguese Heritage Month recognizes the richness of the Portuguese culture, the importance of educating and reflecting upon the heritage for future generations. The City of Brampton acknowledges the valued contributions that the Portuguese community of Brampton has made to strengthen our society and contribute to making Brampton one of the fastest growing and most multicultural cities in Canada. Raising the Portuguese national flag is a perfect opportunity to showcase Brampton's diversity and celebrate our Portuguese heritage. This is signed as Mayor of the City on behalf of City Council to make June Portuguese Heritage Month in the City of Brampton.
O evento serviu ainda para homenagear integrantes da comunidade luso-canadiana, entre eles José Germano, da Brampton Travel Agency, Sérgio Mourato, da Omni TV, e Manuela e Américo Terêncio, da Traditional Taste Bakery. Depois das homenagens, Martin destacou a continuidade do Festival Lusofonia, que na sua segunda edição volta a dar oportunidade à comunidade de celebrar a sua pátria em Brampton.
So why don't we do a festival? Why don't we celebrate what is beautiful about our culture? And Mr. Eduardo Vieira, not only with the vision, but with his hard-earned dollars, made that investment. So I want everyone to recognize and thank Mr. Eduardo Vieira for recognizing that the city of Brampton, that we can do big events and big Portuguese events, and you don't have to go to Toronto, and you can celebrate right here in our downtown.
I want to thank you, Mayor Brown, about the Council, MPP, and of course the community of Brampton. My office is in Brampton, my street is in Brampton, so I invest in Brampton because I trust Brampton is a city of the future. And after the ceremony, I want everybody here to celebrate with us. We have good music, we have good food. And this is going to continue every year. It's what Mr. Medeiros promised me. But I'm going to tell you something. Mr. Medeiros is doing hard work for the city of Brampton. Now we got the second one, Mr. Vicente. And this is it. What we need. We need more young people, more young to be a part and to vote, to support the city because we can be more bigger and grow. Let's vote all the elections because it's important for us. I remember 41 years ago when I came to Canada, I came to Brampton, it's farms all over the place, looked at it. So this is important. Our festival, it's not Eduardo Vieira, it's not Martin, it's the Portuguese community in Brampton. Enjoy the festival because what we want to show, not only the Portuguese, all the cultures in Brampton, all the different nations in Brampton, too, with us, to celebrate our day in Portugal. And tomorrow, Father's Day, it's very important. We have a big entertainment for tomorrow. So after here, we go to the Garden Square, music. It's going to be fantastic. And just I want to thank you to everyone. Eu quero agradecer a todos porque vocês têm a fazer e dar força em que possa mais o Martinho, mais o Vicente, the council, because the council que support this special day. Ajudaram muito este dia. This proclamation, it's not for Eduardo. This is for the Portuguese community. So, in behalf, thank you.
Membros do Parlamento, pela cidade de Brampton, tiveram a oportunidade ainda de divulgar uma mensagem do Primeiro-Ministro Justin Trudeau à comunidade.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Kamala Kara, proud member of Parliament for the beautiful riding of Brampton West. Let me just say, first and foremost, it's truly an honor and a privilege for me to be here, of course, with all my colleagues to celebrate Portuguese Heritage Month. And I do want to take an opportunity to, first and foremost, congratulate the city and Mayor Brown, and of course, Martin and Paul for all the incredible work that you have been doing in our community. You know, I was in Lisbon two years ago, I believe, and it really took me back. And, you know, I was talking to people in Lisbon, Portugal, talking about, you know, the community that we represent. And I truly got to see why why we are the way we are, and the diversity of our city is so strong. So thank you for all that you've been doing. I know Prime Minister was in celebrating Portuguese Heritage Month in Toronto with Julie De Bruzin, the Member of Parliament. So once again, thank you for all that you do. We're truly so proud to represent this beautiful community, and we'll continue to work hard to ensure that you know, our city continues to be vibrant as it is, and it's because of the diversity in our community. So thank you once again. Truly an honor for me to be here, and on behalf of our Prime Minister and everyone on our entire team, a very happy Portugal Heritage Month.
O evento terminou com o içar da bandeira ao som do hino nacional de Portugal. De seguida, no Square Garden, as festividades começaram com um agradecimento por parte de Martin Medeiros.
Olá, boa tarde. Em primeiro lugar, eu gostava de reconhecer aqui o nosso amigo Eduardo Vieira, porque o senhor Eduardo Vieira acreditou na cidade de Brampton. Ele achou que, porque todas as festas portuguesas estão fora de Brampton, em Toronto, em todo o lado, e uns anos atrás nós falámos porque é que não aqui em Brampton. Por isso eu gostava de reconhecer publicamente a coragem, e não só a coragem, mas o investimento aqui na cidade de Brampton, no Sr. Eduardo Vieira. Salve de palmas! Também gostava de convidar aqui o segundo português, também eleito, empresário dos bairros 1 e 5, o Paulo Vicente, o vereador para áreas 1 e 5. Gostava de convidar também um grande amigo da comunidade portuguesa, embora italiano, mas ele também gosta muito da comunidade portuguesa, o vereador Pat Fortini, da áreas 7 e 8. E também o nosso novo, também nova vereador, a Charmaine Williams, também da área 7 e 8. E também temos aqui o membro do Parlamento.
O primeiro espetáculo foi com o cantor Ricardo Cidade. Depois de Ricardo Cidade, o palco foi ocupado pelo grupo folclórico Pérolas do Atlântico. Nem a chuva impediu a comunidade de aproveitar o festival ao máximo.
Eu estou muito contente de vocês celebrarem o Dia de Portugal. Eu sou portuguesa, estou no Canadá há muitos anos, mas gosto sempre de ouvir falar português.
Que todos venham a Brampton, que está maravilhoso, e está a música muito boa, e tive de tudo de bom aqui. O tempo está muito bom, não está nada frio, e venham todos cá fora a despertar desta beleza.
O espetáculo continuou ainda, com Estrelas do Norte em palco.
da manhã, Canadá Televisão, 24 horas por dia no canal 893 da Bell 5, agora também na City TV. Todos os domingos, entre as 11h30 e o meio-dia, acompanha CMC TV, com reportagens da comunidade, entrevistas, entretenimento e muito mais. CMC TV, agora também na City TV. Mais televisão, melhor televisão.